Doing proper keyword research is vital and should be your first step to build a strong foundation for your search engine optimization or any of your online marketing, because if you get this step wrong, everything else you do later on can come crashing down around you. Proper keyword research can be broken down into seven simple steps or phases. Brainstorming. The brainstorming phase can be described as the step where you identify your perfect audience and then properly survey your perfect audience to identify the specific keywords and keyword phrases that they will be using to search for the products or services that you offer on your website. Categorizing. During the categorizing phase, we'll break down our keywords and keyword phrases into specific themes. Examples could be specific products or model numbers of products that your customers are searching for, or perhaps the problems or concerns that your customers are looking for you to solve. The keyword research phase. Typically, a lot of internet marketers jump right into this phase of the process of doing keyword research by firing up some fancy new keyword research tool without having any clue who they're speaking to and what message they should be presenting to their audience. Thus, they fail. And as there are a lot of keyword research tools out there on the market, some free and some that have a subscription, we're often asked which tool we would recommend. Well, that depends, and I'll explain it this way. Just as an auto mechanic has various tools in his toolbox that he can choose from to do his job properly, to be successful online, you should have a toolbox complete with the proper tools to do your job right. Now, I'm not just saying that you should go out and buy every new SEO tool that comes down the road. No. What I am saying to you is that as you progress in your journey and learn SEO and keyword research with us, we will point out some of the various features of the various keyword tools that we will be teaching you. If you find a certain feature of a certain tool fits your needs, then add it to your toolbox. If it doesn't fit your needs, then simply move on. During your SEO training, you'll also discover that many of the free tools that we will be sharing with you also have the same, if not better, features as some of the paid keyword tools. The review phase. In the review phase, we'll be compiling our list of keywords into a spreadsheet, then sorting them, categorizing them. The level of search will tell us how frequently people are searching for that keyword on a daily or monthly basis. The competitiveness level. How many other web pages are competing for that same keyword phrase as we are? And then the relevancy to your website. You'll discover in this phase that many of the keywords that have come up in your brainstorming or through your keyword research are just not worth the time or effort in targeting because they may not have enough search volume or the competition for those words is through the roof and there are more profitable long-tail keywords that you could target instead. The selection phase. After you whittled away at your keyword list in the review phase, you'll often still find yourself with a list of hundreds, if not thousands, of keywords that you have to choose from. That is why many internet marketers say that this fifth phase is one of the hardest for them to master. Well, it really shouldn't be once you understand a few key issues. First off, you're probably realizing the fact there are just not enough hours in a day, let alone a month, to properly optimize your website for all the keywords that you have on your list. Therefore, make it easy on yourself and remember my rule of five. Five keywords equals five articles plus 5 hours a week. Now, I understand that some keywords will be harder for you to optimize than others. That is why I also recommend that you also include a couple root keywords for your long-term investment along with a few long-tail keywords that you can quickly optimize for that will hopefully start paying out you in the short term. Now, I also understand that you have a business to run, and you may not have the time to personally invest in your own time in this phase. Therefore, later in your SEO roadmap video training, we will review other options, such as outsourcing. As your long tail begin paying you the dividends that you're happy with, then consider replacing these with some new long tail keyword phrases, while still working on those main root keywords as your long-term commitment. The testing phase. This is often the most overlooked phase by even the most seasoned internet marketers. Before you go out and break your back and spend hundreds of hours doing SEO for your website, wouldn't it be nice to know that the product or service that you're promoting will actually convert and make you money? Through a pay-per-click campaign, you can quickly launch a campaign using the keywords that you've selected, and if you're making money or just even breaking even, then you know it's worth your investment in moving forward. However, if you find you're not making any sales or conversions, then it's wise to reevaluate the keywords that you've selected and/or to focus on the conversion factors on your website. Wash, rinse, repeat. As you travel in your journey to operate a successful online business, you will want to remember that common phrase written on shampoo bottles, and as long as you're marketing your business. These same set of instructions used to wash your hair should also be applied to any facet of online marketing that makes you successful. Let's again quickly review these seven simple but powerful phases of keyword research that we will be covering with you in this chapter of your SEO Roadmap video training series. 1. Brainstorming. Identify your perfect audience and the keywords that they will use. 2. Categorizing. We will then categorize these keywords into specific topic areas. 3. Keyword research. We will use the various keyword tools such as the Google Keyword Tool, Insights for Search, the Google Wonder Wheel, Market Samurai, Word Tracker, and SpyFu, and save the data into a spreadsheet. 4. Review. We will then review the various keywords and then sort them on the volume of search, the competitiveness, and remove words from our list that may not have enough search volume, or are just too competitive, or just are not relevant to our website. 5. Select. We will then go through our list and, based upon the rule of 5, select the keywords that we will want to target and the launch of our new campaign. 6. Test. We will then test the keywords for conversion using PPC to make sure that they can make us money before we begin our SEO campaign. 7. Wash, rinse, and repeat. In your next video in this chapter of keyword research, you'll discover how you can easily identify your perfect audience and why in many cases you only have one perfect customer that you should be focusing on.